Joe Marano.
Yes.
Are you excited about this word of the day?
I can be bought, Kelly. Okay.
For a price. Bribe him.
I hear you. I hear you.
Are you guys dishing it today?
Yes.
We are.
The word isn't dishing, sorry.
Okay. Yeah. Okay.
That's the one hint you get. That's good. Maybe some extra servings. Maybe I'll give you a little hint. We'll see.
Okay. I'm listening. I'm listening.
Hey, let's talk headlines, though, real quick. It is wedding season. We know this, right?
Yes.
I need your take on wedding parties. I'm in a wedding later on this year or this summer. And I thought the bridal party's a little bit larger than I would have thought. Not this big, though. Kazmi Carter got married in Florida recently. Ooh. See that picture right there? That's all of her bridesmaids.
Yowza!
Wow.
34 bridesmaids.
Nope.
Wowza.
That is a firm no from Jeremy right now.
Nope.
Check it out. She said, she actually has a similar background to you guys. She's been a singer and entertainer.
Aww.
So she said she's lived in New Orleans, Nashville, Atlanta, and she said she's met people all the way that have all been important in her life. She has 6 biological sisters.
That's enough.
They were in. They were in, but she said, all these people are so great. So
these are people that she's met along the way that are just really great friends, and she wanted to have them
all
in her wedding.
All of them. And check this out. She got proposed to on Thanksgiving. They planned this wedding in 3 months.
Oh, wow. That's a lot to
She said, if you gave me some more time, I would have bumped it up to 45 or 50.
Really?
Bridesmaids. Lauren Barnes's main takeaway from this is, I don't know if I'd invite 34 female friends to the wedding. You know?
I'm with you. I'm with you, Lauren.
I was quite private. I wanted mine small.
Really?
Yeah.
Can I just say on that, though, listen, we've been entertainers. We've worked on cruise ships. I met a lot of great people. Don't need them at my wedding.
I was going to say, not wedding guests.
I love them. They're great people.
That's hilarious.
Don't need them.
Oh, boy. All right. We've got another one here that it's crazy to me. Changing an institution, Monopoly, is going digital right now, okay? The Monopoly board is basically, they're instead of a cash bank, they're going to have a digital banker.
Like an ATM?
Really?
Well, like when you pay the rent or you stop on a property, you just input the numbers and then...
And you pay online?
Yeah, you pay online.
I love it.
You pay online, there's no money?
There's no paper money.
I want money. I'm old school. Yeah. I want that money in my hand.
Oh, so you don't even get the cash, you just get a calculator with the number that you make?
Yeah, with the number.
Oh,
and then there's
different.
There's a little piece in the middle of the board that calculates it right there.
That's
a top
hat. Oh, come on now.
So my thought was, I thought Monopoly was educational. When you're playing young, you learn about counting and adding and all this other stuff.
Yeah.
And then, big surprise, Elisa Raffa was like, I liked keeping all the money prim and proper and neat and tidy.
And she probably has it all facing the same way, color coordinated.
She's saying.
Oh, there it is. Yeah. Look at that.
That top hat right there is what you press. You press on the top hat and it calculates it for you.
Interesting.
Well,
we've just all gone intense here.
I don't know if I like this.
I don't like it, though.
I like the blue bills and the pink bills
and
you know what I mean?
It looks like Canadian money.
Yeah, it does.
Yeah.
It does. It reminded me of Canadian money when I was a kid.
So I think we're all kind of against the change. For different reasons.
For different reasons,
For different reasons.
You know what I mean?
That's right, yeah. Mm-hmm.